everybody, Keith Olsen at the Trombone Shop at Schmidt Music back with another instrument review for you. The Greenhole large bore tenor and bass trombones, in particular the new iteration being built with Schilke, have really been getting a lot of attention the past couple of years. They are, you know, extremely handmade. Not a whole lot of folks were involved in production using all of the original Greenhole designs. And because of these small production runs, they've frankly been pretty hard to get a hold of. In the past, we've had a few of the tenors come through the shop here, but up until now, we haven't had a chance to really spend some time with one of the basses. But we got one of their independent bass trombones in, specifically the GB5, more of the box style model. So I'm going to be taking a play on this so you can hear this in action, and we'll do some talking about it afterward. So today, I'm going to be playing all of this on a Malicious 2G. So again, this is the Greenhole GB5 model. So this is their box style bass. They do have a GC5, which is more their con style here. So this has a 9.5-inch one-piece gold brass bell. They do have it available in yellow as well. This is the GB5 3G. One-piece gold brass bell, 9.5-inch, soldered rim. Wider hand slide, kind of the typical Greenhole setup with this, a little bit wider hand slide, yellow brass outer tubes, nickel silver crook, and of course the dual independent Greenhole valves. They do make this as a dependent system as well, if you'd like that. One of the things that I find as a tenor player going to bass is that I have to think a little bit more about how I'm using my air, what I'm doing with it. And frankly, some of this depends on how much practicing I've been doing. When I've been doing a lot of playing, I feel like I've got a little bit better air support. I'm moving things a little bit more. And so when in those cases, I tend to find a little bit more open setup. For example, on bass, like dual axial flow valves just seem to be a little bit more natural for me. If I haven't been getting in as much playing time, sometimes a little bit, you know, the rotor setup, something like that can actually be a little bit more responsive for me. So lately, I've been getting a lot of practice time in, and so I had to really be aware of my air approach with this instrument. When I first started playing it, I was coming at it from an axial flow approach, really trying to move a lot of air into it, and boy, it did not respond all that well. However, when I backed off a little bit and, you know, slowed the air down, thought a little bit more width, a little bit less speed, all of a sudden, boy, it just came to life, which, again, makes sense, especially even with the Greenhole valves. There is going to be a little bit different amount of resistance than on any type of axial flow setup, or especially true bore or any other really open setup. So once I found that balance with the air, I found this instrument to be really efficient. And frankly, that's something I found with all of the greenhorns, the tanners included, is that they are really efficient horns. You don't have to pump a ton of energy in them to get a really great responsive sound. And I definitely found that for me in the trigger register, that's where it really shone through, finding that balance with the air. Everything just came to life. It slotted in really nicely. It had that really nice bass trombone growl, but at the same time, it had core, it had body to the sound. One of the things for me, again, as a tenor player, that shows me that it's a really great bass trombone is how well I can move, especially in and out of the pedal range. It does not come that type of facility is something I have to work at on bass. And so, for example, on the Wagner, moving in and out from the pedal A flat to the D flat or the pedal A flat to the F below the staff, and just how those transitions happen, it felt very natural. I didn't have to do a lot of shifting. I didn't have to do a lot of work with it. That tells me what's going on with this horn here. I did notice that in the upper range, I did experience a little bit of a timbre shift in the sound. And frankly, that part of that may come to your philosophy as to what that sound should be like if on bass trombone. I know nowadays a lot of bass trombone players want to have an instrument that responds and sounds like a tenor in the upper register. However, some folks don't. There are some pluses and minuses to that. So this certainly doesn't feel stuffy and unresponsive to me in the upper register, like especially some older bass trombone designs might. However, it didn't have the same type of clarity and singing quality in it that I thought I had in the middle lower register. Now, part of that might be the gold brass as well. With this kind of setup, maybe yellow brass might give you a little bit more of that quality. You wouldn't experience as much of a timbral shift with it there. But for me, it wasn't anything detrimental. And again, I didn't feel like I had to work any harder with it. There was just a little bit of a sound shift, and that's not always a bad thing. The other thing I did notice with this is it is a little bit wider setup. And even I have fairly large hands, but even holding it here, I did find myself having to shift around a little bit. The greenhole paddles, and I love this contoured wood design on the paddles, but as you can see, it is a little bit wider. And so sometimes what would happen when I was playing, if my hand shifted up too much, all of a sudden the paddle was actually running into my finger here. So if I were going to spend some serious time with this instrument, I would need to use some kind of bracing system to keep everything in place, just so that I felt like I have the best facility possible with it all. But overall, I mean, it really shows again, I think the time, the effort that Greenhoe has put into these instruments, I am continually amazed about how nuanced they are with all of the details, how well I did an unboxing video, how much time they spend from the building to the packing, everything in between. It's really something. So as always, I hope you enjoyed the review here. If you have any thoughts, questions, if you have an experience with the old Greenhoe bass trombones or the new iteration here, feel free to leave those comments. We'd love to hear about them. If you enjoyed the video, consider giving it a thumbs up. If you haven't already done so, think about subscribing to our channel and hitting that notification button. We'd love to have you as part of our community with the channel. And as always, you can find us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. So thanks for watching, everybody.